The entire world is currently going through a serious crisis, which is the COVID-19 pandemic. The SARS-CoV-2 has already opened a Pandora's box for the entire humanity of the Earth. This is the first time ever after the Second World War that the entire world is witnessing an unprecedented situation like this. Due to the complete lockdown, all the economic activities have come to a halt, and this has already resulted in economic recession in many countries. This now seems like a Sisyphean task to defeat the virus unless and until a vaccine is developed, which might not be possible this year. Amidst this lockdown, there is another very important part of our society which has been affected very badly, our next generation, the children. Children are very badly affected by this crisis, directly or indirectly, in various ways, which are discussed here in a brief manner. Fortunately, children are not very largely infected with the SARS-CoV-2, as much as the older people are infected till date today. Much more common has been for the children to tragically lose a parent, family member, or a caregiver to COVID-19. The psychological impact of such loss on children should not be overlooked. Since COVID-19 patients have overwhelmed the entire healthcare system, the children and the pregnant women are very badly affected because they are now unable to access standard care. The drastic measures like complete lockdown and psychological distancing are affecting the mental health of the children very badly. Since scoring, child nutrition programs, maternal or newborn care, immunization services, community-based child protection programs, all are completely or partially closed. So it is resulting in a challenging situation for well-being of the child healthcare system. Prior to this crisis, we were living in a world where 1 in every 5 children is malnourished or stunted. Over half, there is a 53% of the 10-year-old children in low and the middle-income countries, as high as the 4 in the 5 children in poor countries, can't read and understand simple stories. 1 child in 4 under the age of 5 doesn't have their birth registered. So we can say that we have failed to take care of our next generation. So in this current scenario, the situation might be worse than the earlier one. According to IMF, global income has contracted by 3% in 2020 under the assumption that the pandemic recedes in the second half of this year due to the ongoing lockdown and social distancing measures imposed by the governments of countries all over the world to reduce the rate of transmission of SARS-CoV-2. The collapse in income is threatening the livelihood of millions of households with children all over the world. Inputting the forecast from the IMF optimistic scenario in an IFPRI, that is the International Food Policy Research Institute poverty model, indicates an increase in an extreme poverty, that is a PPP, $1.9 a day, this year of 84 to 132 million people, approximately half of whom are children, compared to a pre-pandemic counterfactual scenario. 188 countries have imposed countrywide closures, affecting more than 1.5 billion children and youth. At least 58 countries and territories have postponed or rescheduled exams, while 11 countries have cancelled exams together. The potential losses that may accrue in learning for today's young generation and for the development of human capital are hard to fathom. To minimize these losses, almost 2/3 of countries have introduced distance learning to their pupils, and only 30% of the low-income countries have done so. Around 60% of all children worldwide live in countries where a full or partial lockdown is in place. During this lockdown, many children are witnessing domestic violence against women resulted from anxiety and stress. Such things may affect the mental health of children.